Hello, in this lecture we will find the size of side AE. In the drawing we have square ABCD. We know that line segment DE equals to 8 units. Line segment EB equals to 2 units, and we want to find out the size of line segment AE or side AE. Okay, so first of all, we will join points B and D together by a straight line. Actually, triangle DEB is a right triangle. I'll write it down that triangle DEB is a right triangle. Therefore, according to the Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. So that is to say, if you read to the right triangle, triangle DEB, the hypotenuse is DB, so DB square equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars equals to EB square plus DE square. According to the Pythagoras theorem. I will repeat again, in the right triangle, triangle DEB, in the right triangle, triangle DEB, DB square equals to EB square plus DE square. Okay? The square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. Okay. So DB square equals to EB square. EB is 2, 2 square is 4, plus DE square. We know that DE equals to 8 units, so 8 squared is 64. So we got that DB squared equals to 64 plus 4, that is 68. DB squared equals to 68. So we take a root of this equality and we get that DB equals to the root of 68 units. So we can write here that DB equals to the root of 68 units. Okay? I will present to you rule number one. According to rule number one, diagonals of a square cross the angles into 45 degrees. I'll write it down. The diagonals of a square should remember that ABCD is a square, it is given us in the question. So the diagonals of a square cross the angles into 45 degrees. Okay, so that is to say the diagonals of a square divides the angles into two equal parts. As you already know, all the angles inside the square are right angles, and the diagonals divides the angles into two equal parts, that is to say, into 45 degrees. Okay, so angle BDC, according to rule number one, will be equal to 45 degrees, and angle DBC will be equal to 45 degrees, according to rule number one. So I write it here that angle BDC will be equal to 45 degrees according to rule number one that states that the diagonals cross the angles. And you know that the angles of a square are right angles and they cross the angles, therefore this angle equals to 45 degrees. And angle CBD also will be equal to this angle to 45 degrees. I repeat again, angles BDC equals to 45 degrees and angle CBD also equals to 45 degrees according to rule number one. Okay, so we will define side DC of square ABCD as Y, and actually triangle BCD is a right angle because of the fact that this angle is a right angle, all the angles inside a square are right angles, and especially this angle, this one out of four angles of a square ABCD that equals to 90 degrees. So if we relate to the right triangle, triangle BDC, triangle BDC so in the right triangle, triangle BDC, this right triangle, we know that cosinus 45 degrees equals to y over the hypotenuse, that is actually y over db. Okay, in the right triangle, triangle BDC, cosinus 45 degrees equals to y over bd or db, but we know that db equals to the root of 68, so it will be equal to y over the root of 68. Okay, here db equals to the root of 68, so here we multiply this equality by the root of 68, and we will get that why it is one side of square ABCD y equals to cosinus 45 degrees is root 2 over 2 times root 68. Okay, so y equals to root 2 over 2 times root 68. 68 is 44 times 2. Okay, 44 times 2, and so root 68 will be equal to root 34 times root 2. Okay, so y equals to root 2 over 2, and here we will have root 2 times root 34. Root 2 times root 34. Okay, so we found out that y equals to root 2 over 2 times root 34 over 2. Root 2 over 2 is 2 over 2 times root 34. 2 over 2 is 1. So we got that y equals to the root of 34. Y equals to the root of 34. And as you have already known, all the sides of a square are equal to each other. So all the sides will be equal to the root of 34. So we write here that side DC of square ABCD equals to the root of 34. Side BC of square ABCD equals to the root of 34. Also, side AB equals to the root of 34, and side AD also equals to the root of 34. Okay? So, we also have rule number 2. I will present to you rule number 2. According to rule number 2, if you have line segment AB that subtends two equal angles from the same side, then the quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle, and the four points A, B, C, and D lie on that circle. So I will show you, I write down the rule. Rule number 2. So according to rule number 2, if a line segment AB subtend two equal angles, if line segment AB subtend two equal angles on the same side, then the quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle and the four points A, B, C and D lie on that circle. I will read rule number two again. Rule number two states that if line segment AB, if a line segment AB subtends two equal angles from the same side, then the quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle and the four points A, B, C and D lie on that circle. So I will show you on a drawing what is the meaning of rule number two. Okay, so if we have quadrilateral, first of all, I will draw the circle because I want to fit the circle to the square and to the quadrilateral, so we have line segment AB, subtends two equal angles. Okay, so actually we have line segment AB. This line segment AB subtend angle theta, and we also have the second angle that subtend on line segment AB that also equals to theta. So we actually have two equal angles, both of them are equal to theta, and they subtend on the same line segment AB. Those two angles, they are both equal to theta, and they both subtend on the same line segment AB. Therefore, according to rule number two, the quadrilateral ABCD, this quadrilateral is inscribed by the blue circle, as you can see from the drawing, and the four points A, B, C, and D lie on that circle, as you can see. Point A lie on the blue circle, point B, point C and point D also lie of the same blue circle, and quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by this blue circle. Okay, that is the meaning of rule number two. We have line segment AB subtend two equal angles. Those two equal angles are both equal to theta, they both subtend on line segment AB. Therefore, the quadrilateral ABCD, this quadrilateral is inscribed by the blue circle, and the four points A, B, C, and D lie on that circle. They lie on the circle, okay, on the blue circle. Okay, that is rule number two. We can implement rule number two in our drawing. We have angle DAB is a right angle because it is of the form that it is one of out of four right angles of square ABCD. Angle DAB, this angle subtend on line segment DB. That is actually also the diagonal of the square. So angle DAB subtend on line segment DB. And angle DEB subtend on the same line segment DB. Okay, I'll write it down. Angle DAB, it is a right angle that equals to 90 degrees, subtend on line segment DB. Angle DAB is a right angle and it subtends on line segment DB. And angle DAB, that is also a right angle, this angle also subtends on the same line segment DB. Angle DEB, that equals to 90 degrees, subtends on line segment DB. Okay, angle DAB, that is also a right angle, subtend on the same line segment DB. This line segment in the red color, line segment DB. So we have here two equal angles, they are both equal to 90 degrees, they subtend on the same line segment DB. Therefore, according to rule number two, the quadrilateral AEBD, this quadrilateral, actually, I will paint the quadrilateral AEDB in the green color So, according to rule number 2, quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by a circle, and the four points AEBD lie on the circle. So I will draw the circle with the quadrilateral. We have the circle with quadrilateral AEDB, and it also has two diagonals, diagonal AB and diagonal DE. The quadrilateral AEBD is diagonal AB and diagonal DE. So we have the circle, and inside the circle, actually, this circle of the quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by this blue circle. I will repeat again, according to rule number 2, the quadrilateral AEDB is inscribed by this blue circle, and the four points AEBD lie on that circle, and we also have rule number 2, rule number 3, according to rule number 3, if a quadrilateral is inscribed by a circle, if a quadrilateral is inscribed by a circle, or if quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle, then the product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. So, I'll read rule number 3 again. Rule number 3 says that if quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle, then the product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the squares of to the product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. Again, if quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle, then the product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. So, what is the meaning of rule number 3? The meaning of rule number 3 is that actually, if we have quadrilateral ABCD that is inscribed by a circle, and in this quadrilateral ABCD, side AB equals to A units in its size, side BC equals to B units in its size, side CD equals to C units in its size, and side AD equals to D units in its size, and also quadrilateral ABCD has two diagonals, diagonal BD. We'll define the size of diagonal BD as X, and we'll define the size of diagonal AC as Y. So according to rule number 3, the product of quadrilateral ABCD diagonals, it is actually X times Y. X times Y equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. The first, actually side AD is opposite to side BD, and the product of those two sides is B times D, and we have also the second pair of opposite sides, side AB is opposite to side CD, and the product of the second opposite side, it is actually A times C. So according to rule number 3, the product of its diagonals, that is to say X times Y, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. And the sum of the product of its opposite side, it is actually BD plus AC. Okay? So, we will implement rule number 3 in our drawing. So, according to rule number 3, quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by a circle, and this is actually according to rule number 2, quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by a circle, and the four points AEBD lie on that circle. So, I will draw again the quadrilateral AE and BD. again according to rule number 2, quadrilateral AE BD according to rule number 2, quadrilateral AEBD, this quadrilateral is inscribed by the blue circle and the four points AEBD lie on that circle. But we also have rule number 3 that the product of quadrilateral AEBD diagonals we define diagonal ED of quadrilateral AEBD is X. And diagonal AB of quadrilateral AEBD is Y. That is to say, AB will be equal to Y maintained in size. So actually, according to rule number 3, the product of its diagonals, that is to say x times y, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. So it is actually, if you define side AD as A, side BD as B, side EB as C, and side AE as D, then the product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the squares of the products of its opposite sides. The product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. And the sum of the products of its opposite sides is actually BD plus AC. Okay? But if you look in the drawing, if we implement rule number 3 on the drawing, we get that this quadrilateral AEBD in the green color has two diagonals, diagonal AB and diagonal DE. And according to rule number 3, the product of its diagonals, that is to say AB times DE, AB times DE equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. The first product of the opposite sides, DB, is opposite to AE. Therefore, AE times DB is the first product, AE times DB is the first product of its opposite sides, and we also have the second product of whatever AEBD opposite sides, AD is opposite to EB, so it is AD times EB. AD times EB. So actually, question number 1 is the implementation of rule number 3 in our drawing. Why? Because we know that according to rule number 2, quadrilateral AEBD BD is quadrilateral, is inscribed by the blue circle, and the four points A, E, B, and D lie on that circle. Okay? Then we implemented rule number three, that states that the product of quadrilateral A, B, E, D diagonals, it is actually X times Y, and it equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. It equals to BD plus AC. But if we implement it in our drawing, so we know that quadrilateral ADBE is inscribed by the circle, and quadrilateral AEBD is two diagonals, diagonal AEAB and diagonal DE. And according to rule number three, the product of its diagonals, that is actually AB times DE, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. And the sum of the products of its opposite sides, the first product of its opposite sides, it is actually AE times DB, because AE is opposite to DB. And the product of the two opposite sides is AE times BD. AE times DB. This is the first product of its opposite sides, and we have the second product of its opposite sides. AD is in the opposite sides in relation to EB. Okay, AD is opposite to EB. And the product of those two opposite sides is AD times EB. AD times EB, and according to rule number three, the sum of the products of its opposite sides, it is actually product number one plus product number two equal to the products of its diagonals, it is actually AB times DE. Okay, so the only thing that is left to do now is to put the values of those variables inside equation number one, and we will get the value of AE. The value of AE, actually AE is the only variable that is missing. We know all the other values of the other variables. Okay, we know that AB equals to root 34. Square root of 34. We know that DE equals to 8 units. Okay? So AB equals to square root of 34, DE equals to 8 units. AE is the missing variable that we are looking for. DB, what is the size of DB? DB equals to the root of 68, square root of 68. Okay? Square root of 68 plus AD. AD equals to square root of 34. And EB equals to 2 units, it is giving us the question. Okay, so here we have all the variables, and the only variable that is missing is AE. So here in equation number 1, we substitute 68 is 34 times 2. So the root of 68 is the root of 34 times root 3. Okay, so I'll write it down. We get that the root of 34 times 8 equals to AE is the missing variable that we are looking for. And instead of root 68, I write down root of 34 times root 2, it is actually exactly equals to square root of 68. plus the root of 34 times 2. Here we will divide the equation number 1 by square root of 34, and we will get that 8 equals to AE times root 2 plus root of plus 2. Okay, we canceled the square root 34, so what is left is 8 equals to AE times root square root of 2 plus 2. Okay, here we subtract 2 from equation number 1, and we will get that 6 equals to root 2 times AE. We will divide equation number 1 by root 2, and we will get that AE equals to 6 over root 2. 6 equals to 3 times 2. I'll write it down. 3 equals to, so 6 is 3 times 2 over root 2. Okay, so I substituted 6 by 3 times 2. So here I will multiply this expression by 2, and then I will divide it by, I will multiply it by root 2, and then I will divide it by root 2, and we will get that 8e equals to 3 times 2 over root 2. So we will multiply this expression by root 2, and then we divide it by root 2. So AE equals to 2 times root 2 is 2. So it is 3 times 2 over root 2 over 2. 2 over 2 is 1. So 2 will be cancelled. And we found out that AE equals to 3 times root 2, and actually 3 times root 2 times 3 is 4.243. 4.243 units. So we found out that AE equals to either 3 times root 2 units, or in terms of numbers, it equals to 4.243. Again, AE equals to either 4.243 units, or it equals to 3 times root 2 units. That is the answer to the question. So now I will summarize the lecture. Actually, we wanted to find out the value of AE, this line segment. We have square ABCD. We know that DE equals to 8 units, EB equals to 2 units, angle DEB, this angle equals to 90 degrees, and we want to find out the size of line segment AE. Okay? So, first of all, we connected points B and D by a straight line. And triangle DEB is a right triangle, so we can implement the Pythagoras theorem on the right triangle DEB. according to the Pythagoras theorem, the square of the hypotenuse equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars. And it means that if you relate to the right triangle DEB, that DB squared, that is the hypotenuse square, equals to the sum of the squares of the perpendiculars, equals to EB squared plus DE squared. Okay, according to the Pythagoras theorem. So, DB squared equals to EB squared. EB equals to 2, so 2 squared is 4, and DE equals to 8 units, so 8 squared is 64, 4 plus 64 is 68. So we got that DB equals to 68. We took a root out of this equality and we got that DB equals to the root of 68 units. So this, actually it is the diagonal of square ABCD, it equals to the root of 68 units. Okay? Then I presented to you rule number one. According to rule number one, the diagonals of a square cross the angles into 45 degrees. So we have here diagonal DB of square ABCD, and according to rule number one, this diagonal DB cross the angles of square ABCD into two equal parts. That is to say, cross the angles to 45 degrees. So this angle equals to 45 degrees, and this angle also equals to 45 degrees. Therefore, actually, triangle DBC, this triangle, is a right triangle. And so we can write down that cosinus 45 degrees equals to y over DB. Okay? Cosinus, if we relate to the right triangle DBC, then cosinus 45 degrees equals to y over DB. Okay? But we know that DB equals to the root of 68 units, so we substitute the DB by the root of 68 units, and we got that y equals to, we multiplied this equality by the root of 68 units, and we got that y equals to the root of 68 times cosinus 45 degrees. Cosinus 45 degrees is root 2 over 2. So in total we got that y equals to root 2 over 2 times root 68. Okay? But we know that 68 is 33 times 2. Or the root of 68 is the root of 34 times root 2. Okay? So instead of root 68, we can write down root of 4 times root 2, that is actually root of 68, times root 2 over 2, it is y, that is actually one side of square ABCD. So here, root 2 over 2 is 2, and 2 over 2 is 1. So we found out that y equals to the root of 34 units. So every side of triangle quadrilateral ABCD, every side of square ABCD equals to root of 34 units. Okay? AB equals to AD equals to DC equals to BC equals to the root of 34 units. And we also have rule number two. According to rule number two, if a line segment AB subtend two equal angles from the same side, here we have line segment AB, and line segment AB subtend those two equal angles. Those two angles are both equal to theta, and line segment AB subtend those two angles, that is to say, those two angles rest on line segment AB. Okay? So, if this is the reality, then according to rule number two, the quadrilateral ABCD, this quadrilateral, is inscribed by this blue circle, and the four points A, B, C, and D lie on this blue circle. Okay, again, I repeat again, if we have line segment AB and two equal angles that rest on line segment AB from the same side, then the quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle, and the four points A, B, C, and D lie on that circle, on the same circle that quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed. Okay? So, actually, we can implement rule number two in our drawing, because we have, here we have angle DAB, this angle is a right angle, and this right angle subtend on DB. This angle DAB subtend or rest on line segment DB, and angle DEB, this angle also subtend or rest on the same line segment DB. Therefore, according to rule number two, quadrilateral AEBD in the green color is inscribed by a circle, and the four points AEBD lie on that circle. Okay, again, we know that angle DAB equals to 90 degrees, and it subtend on line segment DB. This angle subtend or rests on line segment DB, and this angle also subtend on the same line segment DB. Angle DEB that equals to 90 degrees subtend on line segment DB also. So we have two equal angles, they are both equal to 90 degrees, and they subtend on the same line segment DB. Therefore, according to rule number two, the quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by the blue circle, and the four points A, E, B, and D lie on that blue circle. Okay, this is the implementation of rule number two in our drawing. Okay, so we know that the quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by the blue circle, and the four points A, E, B, and D lie on this blue circle. Okay? Then we have also rule number three. According to rule number three, so we know that quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by circle. Okay? We know that quadrilateral AEBD in the green color is inscribed by circle. And we have rule number three that talks about quadrilaterals that are inscribed by circle. According to rule number three, if quadrilateral ABCD is inscribed by a circle, then the product of its diagonals equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. According to rule number three, if we have quadrilateral ABCD that is inscribed by this blue circle, then the product of its diagonals, that is to say, x times y equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. And the sum of the products of its opposite sides, it is actually ac plus bd. So according to rule number 3, the products of its diagonals, that is to say x times y, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. This is actually ac plus bd. Okay, so we can implement rule number 3 in our drawing. Why? Because we have quadrilateral AEBD that is inscribed in the green color. This quadrilateral AEBD in the green color is described by a circle. And it has two diagonals, diagonal AB and diagonal DE. Therefore, according to rule number 3, the product of its diagonals, that is to say AB times DE, will be equal to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. And the sum of the products of its opposite sides is actually DB times AE plus AD plus EB. Okay, so we can implement rule number 3 in our drawing. Actually, rule number 3 in general, it looks like this. We have quadrilateral ABCD that is inscribed by the blue circle. Therefore, according to rule number 3, the products of its diagonals, that is to say x times y, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. That is to say it equals to BD plus AC. Okay, so we can implement rule number 3 in our drawing. I will repeat again. Because of the fact that the green quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed by the blue circle, therefore the product of its diagonals, that is to say AB times DE, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides. It equals to AD times EB plus DB times AE. Okay, so this is the implementation of rule number 3 in our drawing. Because of the fact that quadrilateral AEBD is inscribed, the green quadrilateral is inscribed by a circle, then according to rule number 3, the product of its diagonals, that is to say AB times DE, equals to the sum of the products of its opposite sides, equals to DB times AE plus AD plus times EB, equals to AE times BD, AE times BD, this is the product of its opposite sides, AE times DB is the product of its first opposite sides, and we also have AD times BE. AD times BE. AD times BE is the second product of its opposite sides. AD is opposite to EB, and the product of those two opposite sides, it is actually AD times EB, and the sum of the products of the two opposite sides, it is actually AE times BD plus AD plus AD plus EB. Okay, so those two products, the sum of those two products equals to the products of its diagonals. This is the implementation of rule number 3 in our drawing. Okay, and we have all the variables that are missing. The only missing variable is AE. AE is the line segment that we are looking for. We know that AB equals to root of 34, to square root of 34, DE equals to 8, AE is the missing variable, the line segment. We know that DB equals to the root of 68, we know that AD equals to square root of 34, and EB equals to 2. And the only missing variable is AE. So here, we know that 68 is 34 times 2, and the root of 68 is the root of 34 times the root of 4. Okay, so we substitute the square root of 68 by the root of 34 times square root of 2. And here we divided the equation number 1 by square root of 34, and we got that 8 equals to AE times square root of 2 plus 2. We substituted from equation number 1, 2, and we got 8 minus 2 is 6, and 6 equals to the root of square root of 2 times AE. We divided equation number 1 by square root of 2, and we got that AE equals to 6 over square root of 2. And since 6 equals to 3 times 2, all divided by root 2, and here we multiplied equation number 1 by root 2, and then we divided it by root 2, so we changed nothing. Here we have root 2 times root 2 is 2, so here we have 2 over 2 is 1, so 2 gets cancelled, and we got that AE equals to either 3 times root 2 units, or in terms of numbers, AE, line segment AE, equals to 4.243 units. Okay, so we have the answer to the question that AE, line segment AE, equals to 3 times root 2. This line segment AE equals to either to 3 times root 2 units, or in terms of numbers, line segment AE equals to 4.243 units. Okay? So that is the answer to the question. Okay? Thank you very much.